Hola clase, today we learn about por and para. As you know, por and para, they both mean for. However, we can't use them interchangeably. Now here we have them side by side, and as you can tell, we use both of them, por and para, for movement, time, and action. But now, let's dive in so I can tell you what the differences are and when exactly you need to use each one. Por. So if you're going a longer route, or if you're going by a highway, for example, then use por. Por ejemplo, camino por el parque en las mañanas, o voy por la autopista. In both of those cases, it's movement, but it's by, along, or through. Duración. For how long am I doing something? Yo estudio por media hora o camino por 30 minutos en las mañanas. Motivo. Why do you do something? ¿Por qué haces algo? And then, if you're looking for something or somebody, if an element of search is implied, then use por. For example, yo paso por mi niña a las 4 de la tarde. So I pick her up at 4. So I'm looking for her. Therefore, por. And here they give us some more examples. For example, for movement, pasamos por el parque y por el río. Time, how long did you do this for? Estuve en la Patagonia por un mes. Action, or why, the reason, what drives you. Lo hizo por su familia. And then the object of search. Vengo por ti. Manuel fue por su cámara digital. Also, how did you get there? Or how are you going to get there? Por auto, por barco, por avión. Use por in that case. Intercambio. When there's an exchange, then you need to use por. So, as an example, I could say, mi hija limpió la cocina por $20. That means there was an exchange, right? She provided a service and I paid her. Or if I say, let's say that one of my coworkers can't work on a certain day and I substitute her. There's an exchange there. Yo trabajo por ella. O voy a trabajar por ella el lunes. And then medida, unit of measure. So for example, I could say, él estaba manejando a 20 millas por hora. Iba muy lento. Por hora. Examples, ellos viajan por la autopista. Exchanges or substitution. And then the unit of measure that we already talked about. There also are some expressions that you might have already used that carry por. Por aquí, por ejemplo, por eso, por fin. How about para? Para, we used if we're talking about a destination. ¿Para dónde vas? En la vacación, me gustaría ir para España. So, toward Spain. ¿Para cuándo es la composición? For when is the composition? It's due next week. Ah, es para la próxima semana. And then, ¿para qué? What's your goal? What are you working toward? ¿Para qué estudias? Para conseguir un buen trabajo. That's your goal. Then, ¿para quién? So, if you're giving something to somebody, then use para. Example. Destination, salimos para Córdoba. Time or deadline. Él va a arreglar el carro para el viernes. Propósito u objetivo. Juan estudia para ser mecánico. O también propósito. Es una llanta para el carro. If there's a recipient, compré una impresora para mi hijo. Also, if you have an opinion, so I could say, para mí esto es muy simple. For me, this is very simple. Or if you're comparing somebody to others, I could say, oh, esa muchacha, para ser tan joven, canta muy bien. O empleo, yo trabajo para Nuestra Señora del Lago. And again, more examples. Para un joven es demasiado serio. Para mí esta lección no es difícil. In the employment of. Sara trabaja para Telecom Argentina. Now, sometimes you can use either one, but your sentence may change meanings. Caminé por el parque. I walked along the park. It's different than saying caminé para el parque. That meant that you're going, that was your destination, the park. Trabajo por su padre means that somebody was substituting their father, versus trabajo para su padre means that the father was the employer. And that wraps it up with por and para. That's it for today. I'll see you in the next video. Adios.